Good one, wonder. Okay, let us have a look into comb filters. One of the example is H of Z equals to 1 by 2 into 1 plus Z power minus 4. If H of Z equals to 1 by 2 into 1 plus Z power minus 4, then the response we are going to get is Y of N equals to X of N by 2 plus X of N minus 4 divided by 2. See, derived by 4 samples, right? Derived by 4 samples. This is the response we are going to get for the given input sequence X of N. And if I substitute Z equal to e power j omega into this one, we are going to get dt ft. And if you try to simplify this, we are going to end up with this expression. And magnitude of h of e power j omega is mod cos 2 omega. And if you try to plot this one, we are going to get this plot. This is omega versus mod h of e power j omega, where omega is varying from 0 to pi. Pi is the highest possible digital frequency. Here this point, 3.14 something is there, right? This point corresponds to pi, omega equals to pi. And this corresponds to omega equal to 0. This looks like some sort of comb, right? See, the graph is looking like a comb. That's why we are calling it like a comb filter. It's a comb filter. It's a frequency response of this filter, which is looking like a comb. Comb shape. And let me consider h of z equals to 1 by 2 into 1 plus z power minus 8. It's a delay by 8 samples. Then my y of n equals to x of n plus x of n minus 8 divided by 2. And if I replace z with e power j omega, and if I try to simplify that one, then I am going to end up with mod h of e power j omega equals to mod cos 4 omega. And this is also looking like a comb, right? It's looking like a comb. That's why we are calling it like a comb filter. And again, see, due to this extra path, you are having two paths, right? Direct path, x of n by 2, and delayed path. Delayed path means delayed by 8 samples. You are trying to combine those two paths. This is something like a multi-path, right? It's a direct path, and this is an indirect path with some delay by 8 samples. The combined effect at the receiver we are going to get is like a comb shape frequency response. Some frequency components are having a high gain, some of them are having a low gain. For example, if you say 3 dB cutoff frequency, 3 dB cutoff frequency means roughly around 0.7. The gain which is above this one, the constant frequencies corresponds to pass band frequencies, otherwise they are stop band frequencies. Write that you can think. The frequencies up to this point corresponds to pass band. And below 0.7 gain, the constant frequencies are stop band. Write that you can think. Pass band followed by stop band, pass band, stop band, pass band, stop band, like this, right? Some alternate kind of thing we are getting. It's a comb filter example. Such kind of things can be generated in real time also without synthesis. For example, let us consider this thing. Some music signal is coming from this one, this music instrument. It's a direct sound like X of N, for example, X of N by 2. You received through this one, through this direct medium, we got X of N by 2 at this point. And through this indirect one, which one is having more delay? The direct sound or reflected sound? Which is having more delay? The second one, right? Reflected one. Because this is traveling more distance, right? If you want to find the delay, how to find the delay? Let me consider T1 is the time taken for this sound wave to travel from this point to this point. And T2 is the time taken for this sound wave to travel along this path up to this receiver. This is a microphone. And then what is the delay encountered, extra delay encountered by this one? T2 minus T1, right? T2 minus T1 is the delay encountered by this one with respect to this path, direct path. D2 minus T1. And how to compute T2 minus T1? Suppose this path length is D1 and this path length is D2. Then what is your T2 minus T1? Yeah, what can be your T2 minus T1? Direct path corresponds to T1 duration and the distance is D1, distance traveled by the sound wave. And indirect path or reflected path corresponds to T2 duration, time taken along that reflected path, and the path length is D2. Then let me consider V is velocity of sound wave, roughly 330, right? Meters per second. Is it true? It's roughly something like that, right? Velocity of sound wave in air is something like this, right? Now, if you want to compute that extra delay taken by that second path, that will be T2 minus T1, the extra delay taken, which is equals to D2 minus D1 divided by V, right? D2 by V is T2 and D1 by V is T1. In this way, you can compute that extra delay, right? Let me assume that direct path is x of n. Actually, some delay T1 is there, but we are considering T1 as 0 just for your reference purpose. If T1 equal to 0, then tau will be T2, right? Just for for our reference purpose, we are considering like that. This is just one of the examples. Can someone tell me what the meaning of this? It's a direct path with a gain of 1/2, path gain 1/2. It's an indirect path or that the signal received through that reflection, reflected path, through that path. It's delayed by 8 samples, right? Delayed by 8 samples means delayed by 80 seconds. 8 samples means 8 into TS seconds delay, right? Where TS is the sampling period. TS is the sampling period according to our mapping. TS equals to 1 by FS. FS is the sampling rate, right? N minus 8. 8 samples delay means 8 TS delay. Equivalently in continuous time case. Yeah, that's what we are observing here, right? This can be modeled with the help of comb filters, right? Simple comb filters. This is a modeling. It means, suppose if you are having this kind of environment, direct path is there. Along with the directed path, we have reflected path. Then it will be filtered as follows. Some sort of comb filtering, right? Comb filtering. Because you can see, some frequency components will have high gain, some frequency components will have very low gain due to this second path, due to this extra path. That's the effect we are going to get. Some frequencies are having high gain, some frequencies are having low gain. Some sort of filtering is happening, right? This can be modeled as a comb filter equivalently. This is just for introducing some notations. Can you just tell me what is y of n here? Just by looking into this figure. What is y of n? You might have seen such kind of things in your control systems course. Yeah, can you just tell me this one? Block diagram representations, structures. Okay, I'll tell this one and you can answer me the second one. Here y of n is nothing but sum of these two signals, this plus this. This signal is x of n and this signal is delayed by 3 samples. Z power minus 3 means delayed by 3 samples. If this is x of n, this will be x of n minus 3. It means y of n equals to x of n plus x of n minus 3. Now, can you answer what is this? What is this y of n? It's sum of 3 signals, right? Sum of 3 signals. What is this signal? This first signal. Yeah, can someone respond this? What is this?
X of
n. This signal. X of n, right? Okay, then that's fine. Then what is this signal?
X of n minus 3.
Yes, good. That is x of n minus 3. Then what about this signal?
X of n minus 6.
Yes, x of n minus 6. This is x of n plus x of n minus 3 up to this. And further delayed by 3 samples. This is n minus 6, right? Total 6 delays. We have n equals to x of n plus x of n minus 3 plus x of n minus 6. You can say something like there are two paths. You are receiving the signal from three different paths. One is direct telehin offset path. Remaining two paths are reflected paths. Through reflections, you got two different paths. Like that, you can assume. It's a block diagram representation of that one. That's it. And if you try to compute mod h of e power j omega whole square, I want to see that power gain. That's why I took square for this and whole square for this one. See, you know how to find h of z from this, right? What is h of z for this case? First one, h of z equals to 1 plus z power minus 3. And for this case, h of z equals to 1 plus z power minus 3 plus z power minus 6. This is my h of z. Then replace z with e power j omega. And after that, you can compute mod h of e power j omega whole square from 0 to pi interval. Pi to 2 pi, that's not required for us. Just bother about 0 to pi. No need to worry about beyond pi. Because pi is the highest possible digital frequency that we know, right? Already. This effect we are going to get with this filter. Some filtering operation is happening due to this extra reflected path, right? You are receiving through reflected path also along with the direct line of sight path. Due to this combination, this kind of filtering operation is happening. Some frequencies are having more gain. Some others are having less gain, like that. This effect we are getting, right? Same thing is happening here also. Some frequencies are having more gain, some are having less gain. Some sort of filtering is happening due to that extra path, due to that multipath component. And yeah, let me have some example. For example, you are in a theater. You are in a theater, you are watching some movie. Let me consider this is a speaker somewhere as mentioned. You are going to get, let me consider open air theater. Because there are no multiple reflections, it's open air theater where you have reflection only from the ground. Like that, you can imagine. Suppose you are at this location. This is person one and person two location. This person one is receiving this signal and this signal, right? The person two is receiving the same signal with extra delay and some other reflected signal is receiving, right? This is the impulse response for this system one and this is the impulse response for this system two. Like that, you can imagine. The impulse response for this one and this one are different due to this path difference, right? This delay, this T2 minus T1 will not be equal to this T2 minus this T1, right? The two delays are different. That relative difference in time durations, that's different for both of them, right? That's why you can expect different frequency response for each of the receivers. This receiver is having this kind of frequency response. And this receiver is having some other frequency response, but both of them are comb shape only. For example, one of them might be 1 plus z power minus 8 and another one might be 1 plus z power minus 16, delayed by 16 samples, relatively. First one, we are trying to consider like zero delay, the direct path. With reference to that one, we are claiming that this got delayed by 16 samples. Or with respect to this zero delay, we are claiming that extra delay for this one is 8 samples. That's what we are doing. That's why you are going to get a different frequency response of the channel for this case and for this case, right? It means this person is going to hear some sound and this person is going to hear some other sound, right? Due to this behavior, because these two are unequal. The gain introduced by the channel is looking somewhat different for this as compared to this one. It means these two people will try to listen to something slightly different sounds. You may get perception, you may get the equal information, but there is some slight difference is there in terms of what actually these two people are listening. That information content might be same. If this is a voice, this is a voice kind of thing, both can receive the same thing. But the problem is the actual perception might be a little bit different. The information content might be same. The way you perceive the things might be different due to this behavior. Okay, let me consider multipath channel. There are just some examples. This is FIR, right? Finite impulse response filter. 1 by z power minus 1. Let me replace z with e power j omega. And if I try to simplify this one, I will take e power j omega by 2 common, e power minus j omega by 2 common. Then we are going to end up with e power minus j omega by 2 into cos omega by 2, right? And the magnitude response of this one is as follows. This is something looking like a low pass filter, right? This is some sort of low pass filtering operation. This. Let me consider another multipath channel. It's a direct path. Can someone answer me what is y of n here? Y of n equal to? The input is x of n. And what is the received signal y of n here because of this channel? Y of n equals to x of n plus, what is this?
0.2 x of n minus 1.
Yes, 0.2 into x of n minus 1, right? That's what you are receiving. Here, along that reflected path, some attenuation is there. Reflection coefficient need not be 1. Something might be absorbed, right? Something might be scattered. Due to that effect, you got 0.2 gain, less than 1, right? So direct path is having more gain as compared to that reflected path. Like that, you can visualize. Now, if I try to plot mod h of e power j omega for this one, then we are going to end up with this. See, replace z with e power j omega, and after that, if you expand that one, e power minus j omega equals to cos omega minus j sin omega. After that, try to separate real part and imaginary part. Real part is 1 plus 0.2 cos omega. And imaginary part is minus j sin omega. Then what is mod x plus jy? Mod x plus jy. That's root x square plus y square, right? You can do the same thing. Mod of that one is nothing but square root of real part square plus imaginary part square. And after that, if you plot omega from 0 to pi versus that one, mod h of e power j omega, then we are going to get something like this. You can see the peak gain we are going to get is 1.2. Because z equal to e power j omega, right? E power minus j omega, peak value for e power minus j omega is 1, right? At omega equal to 0, e power minus j 0 is 1. 1 plus 0.2 is 1.2. And the lowest value for this one is negative. That's happen when omega equal to pi. E power minus j pi equals to minus 1. 1 minus 0.2 is 0.8, right? So lowest possible gain we are going to get 0.8. 0.8 to 1.2, right? Some sort of filtering behavior is there, right? Some kind of filtering is there. These frequencies are having more gain, and these frequencies are having a little bit less gain as compared to them. Low frequencies are enhanced or boosted, right? Relative to these high frequency components. At least up to that, you can say. You may not say this is stop band, but at least you can say these components are relatively boosted. Low frequency components. And 1 plus z power minus 2. In this case, y of n equals to x of n plus x of n minus 2. And replace z with e power j omega. And if you try to plot this magnitude response of the system, this is 3.14 means pi, omega 0 to pi. We are going to get this kind of response. Some filtering behavior, right? And replacing with let me attenuate that multipath a bit. The gain of this direct path is 1. The multipath gain is, the reflected path gain is 0.7. In this case, y of n equals to x of n plus 0.7 into x of n minus 2. And this is the corresponding magnitude response of the system. Replace z with e power j omega and take the magnitude of that one. Then we are going to end up with this one. This is 1.7, 1 plus 0.7, the peak value. The lowest value is 1 minus 0.7. That's 0.3, right? This is the 0.3 we are going to get. Which we are going to get at omega equal to pi by 2. Because this is e power minus j 2 omega, right? At omega equal to pi by 2, e power minus j 2 omega will become like e power minus j pi, which is nothing but minus 1. 1 minus 0.7 is 0.3. And this is another multipath environment. Y of n equals to x of n plus x of n minus 4. And some comb kind of shape we are getting, right? And this similarly, you can find this. You can try to compare all those figures once we completed this class. Let me go for two multipaths. Two extra paths are there. Here we have only one extra path. In addition to our direct path, we have only one reflected path, right? We are going to get some sort of comb behavior, comb shape, right? In this case, this need not be comb shape. We are having two extra multipaths. Then what is my y of n here? Yeah, what is my y of n? Yes, x of n plus
0.6 into x of n minus 1.
0.6 of n minus 1 plus 0.2 into x of n minus 4, right? Yeah. 0.2 into x of n minus 4. Here we are having two multipaths. In addition to our direct path, we have two extra paths, reflected paths through reflections. Now, if we replace z with e power j omega and replace, okay, separate real part and imaginary part, you can expand that. E power minus j omega equals cos omega minus j sin omega and e power minus j 4 omega equals to cos 4 omega minus j sin 4 omega. And separate real part, imaginary part. After that, take magnitude. Mod x plus j y equals to root x square plus y square. Like that, you can do. And if you try to plot omega from 0 to pi and this magnitude response of the system, then you are going to get something like this. This kind of behavior you are getting, right? Some filtering behavior is happening. Some kind of filtering behavior only, right? Due to these two extra multipaths. It means whatever you are listening, in general, suppose if a person is speaking to you in a closed room or somewhere outside, you won't listen to that sound straight away, right? Along with that directed path, definitely there might be some reflections, right? You'll find some reflections. Due to that reflections, whatever you are listening, that need not be exactly same as whatever the other person is speaking to you. Due to that reflected path, you might have some kind of filtering behavior, right? For your received signal. It will be filtered. Some other frequency components will be boosted and some other frequency components will be attenuated. Less than one gain for them, more than one gain for this one, right? Some filtering behavior, by default, it will happen in regular life also. Even if you can study your speech in your closed room also. And I added one more extra multipath, that reflected path. Y of n equals to x of n plus 0.6 x of n minus 1 plus 0.2 x of n minus 4 plus 0.1 x of n minus 10. So delayed by 10 samples, it means delayed by 10 TS, equivalently in continuous time case. Delayed by 4 TS, delayed by TS. With respect to this, with reference to this one, you see, delayed by 1 sample, delayed by 4 samples, delayed by 10 samples. Like that we are considering. This is also showing some sort of behavior, right? Some frequencies are having high gain, some frequencies are having bit low gain. That means you are trying to listen to some filtered sound or filtered signal you are going to receive, right? after passing through that multipath channel. That's what happening. You may not listen to the exact sound. You may listen to that filtered sound. And let me consider this multipath. We have n equals to x of n plus 0.2 x of n minus 1. And this is the frequency response of this system. Replace z with e power j omega and take mod h of e power j omega. Then we are going to get this. The frequency response. Let me go for, okay, is it FIR system or IIR system? This one. See, here h of n equals to delta of n plus 0.2 delta of n minus 1. H of n. It means the length of this one is 2, right? This is an FIR system, finite impulse response system. Let us go to IIR based multipath channel. 1 by 1 plus 0.2 z power minus 1 whole power minus 1. Okay, can someone expand this 1 by 1 plus 0.2 z power minus 1? Yeah, what is the expansion for this? 1 plus x whole power minus 1 when mod x less than 1. What is this?
1 minus x plus x
plus x square minus x cube plus x power 4 minus and so on, right? And similarly, 1 minus x whole power minus 1 for mod x less than 1 is nothing but 1 plus x square plus x cube plus and so on. Like this you can expect. It means this will be equals to 1 minus 0.2 z power minus 1 plus 0.2 whole square z power minus 2 minus 0.2 whole cube into z power minus 3 plus and so on. Is it FIR system or IIR system?
IIR
system, right? This is an infinite impulse response system. Because my h of 0 is 1, h of 1 is minus 0.2, h of 2 is 0.2 whole square, h of 3 is minus 0.2 whole cube, h of 4 is 0.2 whole power 4, and so on, right? It's going till h of infinity. It's going till h of infinity, right? And the gain is decreasing. You can see, compared to this direct path, this indirect path gain is minus 0.2. If you take magnitude, 0.2 is the gain, right? And this path gain is 0.2 whole square, which is less than 0.2, right? And this gain is less than 0.2 whole square, and 0.2 whole power 4 is less than 0.2 whole cube, and so on. You are having too many paths, right? This can be, this kind of behavior can be observed in a closed room. If you can shut a closed room and if you are speaking a bit louder, what happens is you'll try to receive through multiple reflections, right? Let me consider you are speaking from here. What happens is, and let me consider the receiver somewhere here. You will receive directly, and this reflected path will be there. And what else happens is, this will be reflected, this will come back. Once again, this will go there, this will reflect. Multiple reflections will happen, right? There's a possibility of multiple reflections. This reflection will be reflected once again through this receiver along this direction. It's possible, right? Due to that, you might find such kind of behaviors, these kind of behaviors. And each time when reflection happens, something will be absorbed and something will be scattered. Only some part will be reflected towards you, right? That's why this gain keeps on decreasing as you encounter multiple reflections. In that way, you can think. It keeps on decreasing, right? And this is the frequency response of that system, IIR based multipath system. Replace z with e power j omega and take magnitude of that one. E power minus j omega means cos omega minus j sin omega and take magnitude of that one as usual. And apply the trick 1 by mod x plus j y equals to 1 by root x square plus y square. Now if you try to plot that from omega equal to 0 to pi, then this is the behavior we are going to get. High frequencies got boosted, right? As compared to low frequencies. The gain is somewhere around 0.8, 0.9, right, for low frequencies. For high frequencies, the gain is around 1.2. They are a little bit boosted as compared to low frequencies, right? This behavior might happen. You might try to listen to this kind of behavior. High frequency components might be enhanced. Low frequency components might be attenuated a bit. If you listen in this environment, in this particular environment. And you see 1 by 1 minus 0.2 z power minus 1 whole square. Is simply 1 plus 0.2 z power minus 1 plus 0.2 whole square z power minus 2 plus 0.2 whole cube z power minus 3 and so on. This kind of thing we are going to get, right? And this is a response for this. If you try to plot this magnitude response, low frequencies are boosted as compared to high frequencies. Relatively, right? A AR-based multipath channel. Instead of this z power minus 1, instead of delay by 1 sample, let us consider delay by 8 samples. 1 minus 0.2 z power minus 8 whole power minus 1. It means 1 by 1 minus 0.2 z power minus 8. This is still IAR system. This is still IAR system. Okay, can someone expand this? We have HRZ equals to 1 by 1 minus 0.2 z power minus 8. Can someone expand this? What is the expansion for this? 1 plus 0.2 z power minus 8 plus 0.2 whole square z power, what is this? Yes, what is this?
Minus 16.
Yes, minus 16, right? Yeah, minus 16. The whole square is there. Plus 0.2 whole cube into z power minus 24 plus and so on. Implies my y of n will be x of n plus 0.2 x of n minus 8 delayed by 8 samples plus 0.2 whole square x of n minus 16 delayed by 16 samples plus and so on. Can you just tell me the recursive expression for this? This can be written like this also with the help of recursion. You can cross multiply the two things. Implies y of n equals to how much? If you do this multiplication and do inverse Z transform, then we are going to get y of n minus 0.2 y of n minus 8 equals to 6 of n, right? Implies y of n equals to 0.2 y of n minus 8 plus x of n. Recursively, we can implement in this manner with the help of this system. We can try to implement this kind of system with the help of recursion. It's not possible to implement this straight away, right? Because we need to do infinite number of additions. If you want to implement that with the help of digital signal processor, if you want to integrate this kind of system, reflective system, it's not possible to implement straight away with the help of this. We can implement that with the help of a recursive expression. It's possible to implement this. It's possible. And this is the kind of response we are going to get. Filtered response, right? Okay, can someone tell me what is y of n here? Feed forward. Feed-forward comb filter, feedback comb filter. Yeah, what is my y of n here? The sum of the two, right? X of n plus, what is this?
Alpha into x of n minus k.
Yes, it's good. This is x of n plus alpha into x of n minus k, delayed by k samples, right? Alpha into x of n minus k. This is my y of n. And what is y of n here? This y of n is nothing but sum of this and this, x of n plus this one. This is y of n, right? divided by k samples means y of n minus k into alpha. Alpha into y of n minus k plus x of n. It means y of n equals to x of n plus alpha into y of n minus k. This is my feedback comb. This is my feed forward comb filter. That's what we have seen earlier, right? This is my feedback comb, IAR system, right? Feed forward means the whole power minus 1 won't be there. This is one example for feed forward combo. Which of z equals to 1 plus 0.8 z power minus 8 implies y of n equals to x of n plus 0.8 into x of n minus 8. It's a response I'm going to get, comb kind of response, right? If I have a multipath environment like this, y of n equals x of n plus 0.8 into x of n minus 8, where each sample delay means 8 years delay, equivalently in continuous time case. We are going to get this kind of filtered response. We won't listen to that actual x of n. We'll have to listen to filtered x of n with the help of this filter. That behavior you can listen at the receiver side if that is audio file. And let me go for feedback system. 1 minus 0.8 z power minus 1 whole power minus 1. See IAR system where you can find infinitely many echoes, right? If you expand this, we are going to get 1 plus 0.8 z power minus 7 plus 0.8 whole square into z power minus 14 plus 0.8 whole cube into z power minus 21 and so on, right? Like this we can expect. And due to this closed room environment, we may get too many reflections. Reflection followed by reflection again and again. The things you can observe, but that gives an attenuating. Here 0.8, 0.8 square, 0.8 cube, 0.8 power 4 and so on. That's decreasing sequence, right? Strength is decreasing. And this is a kind of frequency response we are going to get. Replace Z with e power j omega and find mod h of e power j omega. And we are going to end up with this one. Omega from 0 to pi. See omega by pi. It means 1 corresponds to pi. 0.4 corresponds to 0.4 pi. 0.2 corresponds to 0.2 pi. Like this. Some of them got boosted a lot, right? You can see. This frequency got boosted a lot. Very high again. And this frequency also got boosted by a lot. This also got boosted by a lot. This frequency component also. Due to this multipath behavior. It means we are going to listen to this kind of filtered signal at our end. X of n got filtered by this filter. And that output we are going to listen actually in a closed room. Equivalent closed room for this. And you can have a look into this example also. Multiple echoes. And if you try to expand this IAR system, 1 plus 0.8 z power minus 4, 1 plus 0.8 z power minus 4 plus 0.8 whole square z power minus 8 plus 0.8 whole cube into z power minus 12 and so on, right? It means we are having h of 0 equals to 1. See h of 0, right? Equal to 1. This is impulse response. N versus h of 1. And h of 1 is 0, h of 2 is 0, h of 3 is 0. We have once again at h of 4, right? Because we have 0.8 into z power minus 4, where 0.8 corresponds to h of 4. H of 4, this is h of 8. H of 8 equals to 0.8 whole square, and h of 12 equals to 0.8 whole cube. H of 16 equals to 0.8 whole power 4, and so on, right? It's a decreasing. It's an equivalent behavior. This keeps on going till infinite index.